I found this at Goodwill recently. It's a compact fluorescent light bulb, but as you can tell by the appearance and size of the box, it's rather old. I would guess it's from the early to mid 90s. And look at the original price, $21.49 for one bulb. I paid $3.99 for it. It says 52 watt replacement using 15 watts, 700 lumens, has a 9,000 hour life rating. It claims you'll save $26.64 in energy costs. That's probably over the entire life of the bulb, I would guess. It is from GE. It says Energy Choice Compax Light Bulb, although there's obviously nothing compact about it. Enjoy the long life and soft, warm light of the Energy Choice Compax Light Bulb. It says it can be used in any position, but do not use in enclosed fixtures, do not use with dimmers, do not use where lamp may contact moisture, and for indoor use only, may not start at temperatures below 32 degrees Fahrenheit. It is UL approved. A lot of information on the back, some kind of old sticker on here. I can't see any date code though, but definitely a rather old sticker. It was made in Japan. It's an FLB15/T-L, and they're comparing it to a GE Wattmeiser Plus 52 watt light bulb. I haven't seen one of those in a long time. Those bulbs are rated for 2500 hours at 700 lumens. It does not have any warning about the bulb containing mercury, and it doesn't have any instructions on recycling the bulb when it gets burned out. But it does say star bottle within lamp base contains 0.33 micro CI PM147. I have no idea what that means. If we open it up, we get this packing material. And this is the bulb itself. Look at the size of this thing. And this is a glass enclosure. Let's see. FLB15/TL, 15 watt, made in Japan. And a big caution warning here. If you compare the size of that to a standard light bulb, it's just massive and it weighs a lot too. It's very heavy. It just barely fits in a standard lamp holder thing here. So let's try it out. It's a preheat bulb. That's pretty cool. You don't see those anymore. It appears to have a U-shaped bulb within that glass enclosure. Can't really see it on camera, but it definitely has a U-shaped bulb in there, and it is getting brighter. And it's definitely a soft white bulb. It has a sort of yellowish glow. See how quickly it restarts. I set my camera's shutter speed as fast as it'll go, and you can kind of see the U-shape of the bulb now. Though it's making the camera do weird things. It's like changing from green to pink on the camera. Look at that. Now normally compact fluorescent bulbs make quite a bit of radio interference, especially on AM radio. So let's see how bad this one is. If you put the radio right up to it, it does make some buzzing, but about a foot away it's fine. So that's pretty good. It's not too bad. I don't have any 52 watt bulbs to compare to because they probably haven't made those in almost 20 years now, but I do have these 53 watt halogen bulbs. So I have my camera set on a fixed exposure and shutter speed so you can compare how well this lights up the workbench here. And I'll switch to the other bulb. Okay, this is with the 53 watt bulb, which is rated at 790 lumens, while this is rated at 700, so it is slightly brighter and also a whiter color temperature because these are the Philips natural light blue tinted bulbs. But if I had an actual 700 lumens bulb to compare it to, I think it would be pretty much the same. So despite being probably 20 years old, this does seem to live up to its rated brightness. When I start it up, you can hear a popping noise on the radio. If I turn it on in the dark, you may be able to see the purple glow of the starter. And I found this receipt tucked in the box from Rupp's Sayreville Hardware in Sayreville, New Jersey, dated April 17th, 1992. The sale price was $11.99, so that was a pretty good sale compared to the original price of $21.49. So, looks like this bulb is from 1992. And these days, 15-watt compact fluorescent bulbs from GE are considered to be 60-watt equivalent instead of 52-watt equivalent. And they have a rating of 8,000 hours. Well, this actually has a 9,000 hour life, so they haven't made that much progress in the past 20 years with these bulbs, except that they're much smaller and cheaper now.